scale of nature is global. The interest is growing. Our friends across the pond in the United States would now like to run their International Festival for Business and ask us for advice on how they go about doing that, learning on the examples that we are developing here in the Portland City region. The reputation of the festival, given previous successes, is growing, and the scale of events which are running in the city region is now quality and magnitude that we couldn't have aspired to have had at the first festival in 2014. Some quotes on there from businesses in Knowsley, in Liverpool and Stockport, from people who have brought their companies to the business festival and have benefited from the interface between their companies and those who attend the festival. Later on this presentation, the festival director Ian McCarthy will talk about the work that is going on with the city region and colleagues to make sure the city region benefit from the festival and companies benefit from most they can from their attendance and participation in the festival. But the previous history of where the resources that have been secured by the festival have gone, around 47-48% of what's been achieved has gone into the city region and its city region businesses, and Ian will cover one or two cases, I think particularly in rural and Sefton, where there have been particular benefits. The numbers from the previous two festivals have been well promulgated, subject to independent research. They're very impressive. But 2018, we're targeting 30,000 delegates to be in the city region over the 3 weeks. And the progress in terms of securing those delegates to date is already very impressive, and I'll cover that in just a minute. Each day the festival has a different theme, and those themes are on the slide behind us. Those themes have been discussed with government, with McKinsey's, with the CBI, with the FSB, the Federation of Small Businesses, with the Institute of Directors, and were arrived at after a lot of consultation. It seemed to be extremely popular with people out there who can now see that if you're involved in manufacturing, you have to be in the city region on the 20th of June, because that will be the major event in the world of manufacturing which takes place in 2018. Each of the days is now filling up in terms of speakers and third-party events, and the programme is now fully detailed on the website, which is up and running, and I would suggest that colleagues look at very closely. The facets of the festival are on the slide behind me. We will have over 100 international organisations exhibiting what they want to do in terms of their interest in doing deals in the UK. As of last night, around about a dozen delegations from China have signed to be here. As of last night, delegations from Latin America, the Middle East, Europe, America have signed up to be here. With somewhere around 35 delegations confirmed now as coming to Liverpool from across the globe. There are 257 delegations from across the globe who've now asked us for confirmation that they can attend the festival. In some cases, they will require visas, which is why they have to purchase in the first instance, so we can approve their visa entry into the UK. In terms of the future stage, we've secured over 45 speakers from all industry sectors that you saw on the previous slide. The Director General of the CBI will be here. Most Secretaries of State from government will be here. The Institute of Directors Chief Executive will be here. And there'll be some announcements which Steve will make in an event in February to be held with Andy Burnham for the Northwest to promulgate the festival further to Northwest businesses, which will be held at the end of February, of some global names who will now be coming to the festival to speak on the future stage. In terms of events and conferences, the good news is we are virtually sold out. If you brought another event to us today, we'd struggle to accommodate it. What that means is that against the target of 30,000 delegates that I said before, we want to attract as our audience, those events and conferences themselves will bring 13,000 delegates, which we've already signed up for. Of those 13,000 delegates, out of the 30,000, around 27% are international delegates from those kind of locations I mentioned before. So this is becoming a global event, and those delegates take us roughly to about two-fifths of the audience we want to attract. When we sign up whatever number of those 257 delegations that are pending, went on sale recently, and sales, are, I could say today, are very steady, but they will increase as we get more promulgation. Ian and I are due to meet the Director General of the BBC very shortly to discuss BBC coverage during the festival, and then lead it to the festival, which will further promulgate the message about this, this festival taking place in the city region in June. Last time, some people said the format was very attractive, but slightly too corporate. This time, decided to go for a more, people like Catherine Gardell used to be a quirky person, which is Wayne Hemingway. And Wayne has produced a more quirky design this time, which I think you'll see in outline form there, which again covers for you well, all of the facets in the previous slide will appear in that layout on the exhibition centre if you take it for 3 weeks. The construct will take place 3 or 4 days before 12th of June when we open for business. On the 12th of June to open the first week, and on the 19th of June to open the second week, and on the 26th of June to open the third week, there will be a VVIP here in each of those 3 weeks, and we'll make announcements about who they are once the security clearances have been given to make such details available. If you go on the website, you'll see each day's programme now outlined. The events, the speakers, the facilitators, what's taking place on the future stage, what's taking place in every aspect of the festival. The government have signed up to take 30,000 square feet to showcase what DIT and BEIS are doing, and we're under instruction from Greg Clark to use some sessions to promulgate to the international audience the main facets of the industrial strategy which was recently published. That's another example of our life sciences day where we're working very closely with Janet Hemingway and others, and some global speakers have been secured from the US and the Middle East to come in and talk about their life science experience, and companies have been signing up again from China and from the Middle East and America to take part in events on that day. Since I last presented here, we've signed up the UK Business Angels Association to bring in numbers of investors every day into the festival, and each day is a new facet. There will be a pitch session on the future stage where businesses can pitch to business angels to secure funding for their business idea. And we're getting a lot of interest from SMEs across the country who want to come and pitch for funding for their particular business on each of those days. The partnerships are detailed on that slide. The sponsors which we've announced are HSBC, British Airways, Davis Wallace Forster. There's another announcement to be made in the next few days of a partner for the Life Sciences Day, and further announcements to be made shortly of other partners. The CBI, FSB and IOD. And the partnership that the festival enjoys as part of the GREAT campaign will give us further coverage across government. Securing a royal patron has been very helpful. Occasionally when we go abroad on this festival, not everybody knows the name of our Prime Minister, even though I believe they should, of course, but they do know who he is. And that does help to open some doors. And that gloss that it's brought to the festival and his willingness to write out to certain speakers and certain organisations to attend is proving to be extremely beneficial. Our reach to across the globe needed to be further strengthened, and so we've signed deals with all of the organisations on that slide, covering virtually the whole of the globe. And they are tasked with bringing in businesses, chains of commerce, relevant partner organisations, venture capitalists from across the globe, and that's proved to be hugely successful. That pipeline of 257 cities or countries who want to be in Liverpool city region in June is largely down to the partnerships we signed with those organisations. In terms of those partnerships, the seniority is best described by the fact that the Italian Director of Commerce from the government wants to be in, as you've just told down, obviously, Jim, well, I can't add that. I didn't think it was that funny. I thought it was doing well, Asif.
You did very well.
Thanks. The Director General of the Italian Trade Agency is here. We're expecting at least a number of city and city region mayors from across the region. And in the case of a number of countries, we're expecting government ministers to be here as well. I've just started the dialogue with Stephen Frank about how we ensure that the relevant politicians and senior people get access to Stephen particularly. to Ian, I'll come back to for questions, is Ian to be leading the work as the director of the festival with the city region, the city region colleagues, about how this is being developed in partnership with the city region.
Tell Max not to wear the blue tie, it looks like we've got dressed together this morning. I guess I'd just reinforce that the whole purpose of the International Business Festival is to deliver benefit for the Liverpool City region. In a previous life in Manchester, organising the Commonwealth Games, we used to say we're not doing this because we like organising sporting events. And that's something that stayed with me in terms of why we're doing this. And I wanted to reinforce that from the start. I think the second big reason that we need to remember is that there's an association between events and places. And that takes time. So the Farnborough Air Show, the Edinburgh Festival, the Mippin Property Show takes time. But there's an opportunity here for the city region to put something in place in the next decade that's part of an international business calendar where people are coming to Liverpool city region on a regular basis to do business. Secondly, if anyone needs reminding, this provides the opportunity for people to see the transformed place. You won't invest somewhere if you haven't been there, and the festival provides the opportunity for tens of thousands of people to come to the city region, see the place firsthand, and we know there's still misconceptions, and make a judgment about what a fantastic place the city region is. I think, thirdly, the slide talks about leaving legacy. Not only will the event bring enormous benefits over the 3 weeks, but we will have an integrated youth strand so that young people get free access. 1,000 tickets, Max has talked about charging, 1,000 tickets for the city region and just a wee bit beyond to enable young people 16 to 24 to come and experience the international economy that we're now growing, they will grow up in rather. The investment programme with UK Business Angels, we're developing a legacy programme with them so that there's a network of local agents that angels, if I can get the word out, that's left behind after the festival that's available for businesses to access. Max has talked about days and topics and thinkers. It gives the opportunity for businesses to be exposed to the world's, genuinely, the world's and the UK's great business speakers. So it helps us to revitalise and energise and bring all those new ideas and innovation to the city region businesses. And I guess finally, I think Max has slightly underplayed the relationship with Innovate UK, who will bring that innovation hub to the festival. And that, again, that whole network of catapults across the key sectors that will bring their business base to the city region, to the festival, and the opportunity for businesses to engage with that. Track record of 14 and 16. This is based on a thorough evaluation. Just to reinforce, some 750 businesses responded to the evaluation in 2016, and these figures, the outcome figures, are based on that. This is to a framework which was agreed by government, by Piers, and it seems to me that whatever these numbers are, they are really substantial. And I guess business people in the room will reflect on the fact that conceptually, if you bring businesses together, the right businesses in the right space, and let them have a dialogue, then outcomes will come from that. Relationships, new buyers, new investors, new ideas, new ways of working together. So that high level summary that Max has referred to is underpinned by some of those cases that are there. Real cases of businesses from Sefton, from Wirral, from Knowsley that say, yes, we did business, we got X hundred thousand pounds worth of sales or investment or jobs from the festival. So moving on to the current festival, June, which is the most important, we have a funding agreement with the combined authority. And and a business case and grant agreement that we're working and very focused on delivering, which points to those outputs in terms of domestic sales, exports and jobs. Those are not for the festival, those are for the city region. So the 700 jobs created as a result of the festival in 18, substantial numbers. Disproportionate outcomes, there's 3,000 businesses attending per day, that's where Max gets his 30,000 from over the 9 or 10 days. Undoubtedly, a high proportion of those will be from the city region and a bit wider. You organise something in Newcastle, 50% of the people come from the North East. It's as simple as that. That's the way that the event industry works. So we will have disproportionate benefits in any case. And those sectors, which are the future drivers, the 9 sectors, they also, let's not forget, relate very, very closely to the priorities of the city region. So Halton's interest in logistics or science, or Wirral's interest in energy, or Halton in manufacturing and St Helens in manufacturing. We've looked at the boroughs and brought that synergy to those that Max has highlighted. So in conclusion, in terms of maximising the benefit, we have a local sounding board. The group has met and includes officers, colleagues and businesses from all of the local authorities and business agencies, been meeting for 12 months, and our objective is to maximise the benefit from this event to the city region. In practical terms, that means 3 things. Maximise the number of businesses that attend from any borough, and we've distributed and are distributing tickets with promotional codes to offer discounts through agencies in Halton, St Helens, Sefton, etc. Secondly, bring businesses and encourage them to exhibit in the international marketplace that Max put up as a component. Let's make sure our best businesses are there on the festival floor. And finally, the international delegates. There will be, our target is 100, we will exceed that. Those delegations need to get out and about across the city region, and our colleagues are working with colleagues again in across all the boroughs to make sure they don't come into Liverpool and the exhibition centre, but they get out to Darsbury, they get over to the Wirral to see things that, that businesses and the interest need to see across the water, etc. So I commend the festival and the efforts that are being made to make sure that this leaves a real and lasting benefit to the city region. Thank you.
Thanks, Ed.